I've got a secret. Colorado is filled with so many famous Jeep trails, like Black Bear Pass, Engineer Pass, Imogene Pass. That's just to name a few. They're typically in the Silverton, Ouray, and Telluride areas. I've got a secret for you. Colorado, the whole state, is filled with so many scenic trails, it's unbelievable. And I'm gonna share a secret with you. I found a great little scenic overlanding oasis called the San Luis Valley. We're up in the mountains in Colorado. This is so amazingly beautiful and peaceful, and you can just see for miles. That's what I love. You know, I've realized on this trip, it's not always about the extreme rock crawling. It's not about the obstacles. You know, those are fun and everything, but sometimes it's just nice to be, you know, out in nature and taking in all this beauty. There's no one else out here. There are no other off-road vehicles out here. And it's just us and nature. And it's so peaceful and beautiful, and I'm just awestruck at the beauty. The San Luis Valley in south central Colorado, an overlander's oasis in the mountains. A bit supernatural and mysterious, the mystical San Luis Valley is one of the more unusual and beautiful parts of Colorado. The impressive mountain peaks of the Sangre de Cristo range, with 14,000 foot jagged peaks on one side with rolling sand dunes, then wide open spaces, and the spectacular San Juan Mountains on the other, with majestic waterfalls, hot springs, and the headwaters of the Rio Grande River. A trip to this valley should be on everyone's Colorado bucket list. There is definitely something magical about being in such a breathtaking place. It is one of the largest high desert valleys in the world, with the highest altitude of 8,100 feet, spanning over 65 miles wide and 125 miles long. There is just so much to explore and see.
The view is simply breathtaking.
The San Luis Valley offers so much exploration for the explorers out there. The trails are mild to easy, and a stock Jeep will do perfectly fine. I will share a few of the places you can take your Jeep and explore. One of the first places I explored was Elephant Rocks and the Natural Arch. Elephant Rocks is just north of Del Norte, Colorado, US Highway 160 to Colorado 112, head north about 3 miles, then turn on to Rio Grande County Road 33. That takes you to Elephant Rocks, a unique geological blueprint to the Earth's history. The beautiful rock formations in this area are attributed to the largest pyroclastic eruption in the world. That means a volcanic eruption producing and ejecting rock fragments. The eroded ash forms the elephant-shaped boulders. It is part of the San Juan volcanic field and the La Garita caldera. The Elephant Rocks area is a unique area that was once habitat for the Colombian mammoths that lived in the San Luis Valley long, long ago. The giants once walked here. Local legend has it that these creatures left their mark on the rocks. The area at Elephant Rocks is mainly grassland with scattered massive boulders laid out, and there is a trail through these scattered rocks. That trail will take you across the grasslands to the Natural Arch, which was formed by the action of wind, rain, and weather on the volcanic dome. On the other side of Natural Arch is a trail that takes you along Old Woman's Creek, where you can explore open meadows and dark forests in the National Forest Land. Another great scenic route is just west of Del Norte towards South Fork, Colorado. Forest Road 610, Alder Creek, which takes you around to Pool Table Road in the Wheeler Geological Area. A must stop. This area has some of the most amazing geological views. The Wheeler Geologic Area started 30 million years ago. When there was that volcanic eruption, unique spires were blown into the atmosphere by the explosion of the La Garita caldera. The views in the Wheeler Geologic Area are remarkable geologic formations. Because that volcanic tuff didn't compact, it has eroded into the most beautiful spires and rounded canyon walls in the Wheeler Geologic Area. The National Forest Service advises you to plan a whole day trip to travel to the formations, the road can be extremely rough with deep ruts. High clearance vehicles are recommended. You can also hike to the area. Now, if you make your way back to Forest Road 610, I suggest you find your way to Forest Road 630, which takes you to the Aqua Ramon Mountain. The view is spectacular coming down the mountain back near the town of South Fork. I recommend using the Gaia GPS app. Another fun place with amazing views is Toll Road Gulch near Bonanza, Colorado. The road is very narrow at points along the shelf road, but definitely worth the views.
The snow has stopped us.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Bishop's Rock, another fun little mountaintop exploration with some great views. The trail is off County Road 15, south of Monte Vista, Colorado. Also off County Road 15 is Jasper, Colorado, which has some amazing forest roads with breathtaking views. The forest roads near Ghost Town, Summitville, Colorado, are also great to explore. East of Antonito is a cool bridge over the Rio Grande River called the Lobatos Bridge. There is a 4x4 road near this bridge that runs north along the Rio Grande River. There are so many places to explore in the San Luis Valley. This place definitely calls to your soul. Check out another video of mine, Must See Small Towns in America. I share some more spots in the valley you must see. Comment below if you have come across an overlanding oasis you want to share. And please click the red subscribe button to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it with your friends.